guys. So having a portfolio is very common for B2B business or also for the freelancer. Like, we want to showcase some stuff. One of my friend is not really fond of the default design from Divi, so I tried to customize the style that you want, and I'm gonna walk you through as well how you can achieve this kind of design, okay? And I'll walk you through how you can configure it, and I also create an article version on that in case you cannot follow my instruction on video. So I'll create an article version on that. And the things that we will need for this is, of course, a Divi themes, second, a custom CSS, and a class that will hold for our modules, and maybe JavaScript, but I'll try to avoid using JavaScript for that. We will try to stick CSS. And now, without further ado, let's begin. Hi guys, so another Divi customization tips for today, and this is the default portfolio on Divi, and she just sent me her ideal design, and she wants this kind of vibe, like a full image, but if you hover the image, there will be a text and the category, and then this button linking, not button, an icon linking to the portfolio page, okay? So this is the default style on Divi. Now we will customize this one, and we will try our best to look at better, like this, almost similar like this, okay? Now this one is three columns, but I'm gonna use four columns for her because her logo is super small, and I don't think it would be also ideal for three columns design, so we will just use four columns. We are good on that. Now I'm going to add a design here, an ID, and we will call it modified portfolio, okay? Now make sure also that the row are in full width, so it should be full width, and then you can maximize the width of your module as well, okay? And then let's update that one. Then after that, we need to select the overlay. Now I'm gonna choose her branding color, so let's copy that one. By the way, I'm using color picker extension to grab the color. Now let's go to the portfolio and then design and the overlay, and I'm gonna use a solid purple color for her branding. And then let's update that one. And now, okay, we have this style already. Now we will change the color of the icon. Now go back to the menu, design, and let's look for the word. Where is the icon here? So icon. So icon should be gray. Overlay white. The icon should be white, and the hover overlay should be purple. Okay, my bad. Then let's see, let's refresh that one. So we have this already, so we're almost good in that. Now I need to actually, I already have the code in here, so I'll just explain with you later. So first is we will set the margin. So I'm gonna set the margin item, this one, to be, because there are some margin at the right, so I'm gonna set the margin to 0. So go to the theme options, okay, and then general, and then put the code here. So let's put that one. By the way, make sure that you put an ID on the advanced section to make sure that your CSS code will work on the theme options. So as you can see in here, like there's no more space. So I already have this one. So let's just, next is the weed filter. So I'm gonna I'm referring to this part in here. So this part in here, I don't want it to be 100%. I want it to be at least 80%. So let's put that here. Actually, let's just add a comment so we know where the portfolio CSS is ended. By the way, I'm gonna create a article version on this for the code, so just to make sure. So we already have this one, so almost the same with this style, but probably you can make it center. I'm not bothered with this part. I'm more concerned in this part. Okay, next would be we want to let me just, okay, this one should be at the end first. I'll just put it at the end of our code so I can explain with you later. So next part will be the images. Okay, so I want the images to have a height of at least 300px. She wanted to be in square type instead of rectangle type, so we will put this code again. Okay, and then saved and refreshed. So we already in that part, it's already in square mode. Now the last thing is we want to be the width every grid item, this part, so it should be 25%, because we want it to be four columns, right? So 100% divided by four would be 25%. So we would get that and then put it in here again and then save and refresh. Okay, so we're almost good to go in here. I mean, this vibe is almost already almost there. So next would be the overlay. Let me just remove this part. Why am I putting this one? Overlay background. I don't think that's necessary. Yeah, I don't think that's necessary. So let's just skip that. So next would be, I will need to...
By the way, if you find my video helpful, feel free to subscribe to my channel. Click that subscribe button and that like, thumbs up, and the bell notification if you want to receive new videos from me.
Okay, let me just... I don't think that's necessary. Wait. Overlay, that would be for the spun. Wait. Okay, so actually we need that. However, this one should be not needed. Refreshed. Okay, so we have this code here, which is modified portfolio spun overlay. So last time our overlay is in full width, right? So if I comment this down, let me just remove this and show with you earlier. So when we hover the image, it's full width, but we want to copy this kind of vibe, like this part. So this is 50%, I believe, but I'll just use 70% for that, because our image is not quite big. It's just a logo, so I don't think we need to really make the image visible. So we have already this kind of vibe in here. We're almost there, so this part should be pushed there. So we will push that. Okay, sorry. So I'm going to copy this. So this part will, this code will push the image. About 23, and I need to add a, okay, so I'm going to paste this, but I need to add a ID for that. It's actually wrong. Okay, so we already have that, and then I will save. Let's see how it looks in here now. So we're already pushing this header, this headings and the category. So we're almost done. Now I don't want to be, I don't want this title and category static. I mean, it should be only show if you hover the image. Okay, so what we will do is we will add a code in here under the portfolio. I will add, by the way, you need to add this, sorry, I forgot. You need to add all of this code here for the, just copy this one, filters. So we need to copy this ad media code that I created to make your website, to make your grid portfolio responsive. So I'm going to copy that. And again, I will create a article version of this. I always repeat that because sometimes someone sending in a message that, where is the code? I mean, we need that heck code. So yeah, I'll create an article version for that. So after you have the media version, we need to hide this category in this title. So go back to the code, this part. So this part, modified portfolio grid ID H2 and modified and grid item post meta. Now I'm going to hide that. So we need to hide this. Okay. So already hiding that one. Now we will add this code in here. So let me just rename this one. I spelled it wrong. Hoover activated. And then we will add it here. I mean, in any place actually, but let's just add it in here. So add it there and then save. Okay. So, I mean, it's still not working, right? So it's still not working because we are hiding the title and the category. Now we need the help of jQuery to make that title visible. So go to the general and then integration and then put this code here. Okay. And actually I renamed that Hoover activated. Hoover activated. So put this code into the body section and save and then refresh. Hoover activated. I believe I have some issues with the typo. Okay. So copy this code here, my mistake, and I don't think we need that one. But I think this one will do. Actually, let me just copy that one because we already have the portfolio. Okay, and then refresh. Wait a minute. Okay, I think I'm gonna modify this one because that is super long. Copy, put it here, put it there, put it there. Again, I have an article version in this. I'm so sorry if it's getting you confusing, but basically I am hiding the title and the category. And then once they hover the image, then it will be visible again. Okay. So this is the code all about. So it's saved and then refreshed. And interesting way it's not working. Let me just pause this a while and I'll get back with you shortly. Okay, my bad. I have a mistake in this. It should be that one. It should be like that. I mean, there's no space. And let's save that one and refresh. And it should be working. Yeah, so it's already working. We're already good in this. Last would be, I need to change this title color and the category color. How we can do that, so go back to the enabled visual builder. So we're already good in the CSS and the jQuery. We're good in that. We just need to change the color on the design tab. And I did not set a color for that because I want it to be more dynamic so she can change it. So the title color is currently in pink, called burgundy. Is that? Yeah, something violet. So white, I'm going to turn that into white. And then the category you should be not black, but white. And then let's saved. And then visuals builder exit. And boom. Pak, pak, pak. Pak, 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 pak. And let's open this part. And we're ready. I mean, we already have this kind of vibe. But I think I need to add more animation in here. I can add animation. But I think, let me just open this. Yeah, we're already 17 minutes. So that's it. And I hope you find this interesting. Comment down below if you have other designs you want me to modify. I can consider it taking a footage on my next video. And that's it for today, guys. If you want to receive more videos related to Divi, then make sure you comment down below or click that like button so I know that you love seeing videos related to Divi or WordPress. Otherwise, I'm gonna switch to other topics.